Hi guys, welcome back to another weekend vlog. It is currently Friday afternoon and I am in the middle of a work day, but I'm taking a little break and I'm gonna go to a bridal appointment. I have to go and get my, I'm like going through my dress alterations right now, and I have like 3 or 4 appointments total with the lady that's doing my dress. And so yeah, I'm gonna go and see her right now. I'll talk to you guys more in the car, but I thought I would show you guys my outfit of the day just because I haven't really shown an outfit in a while. So I am wearing this little sleeveless, I'm wearing this little sleeveless turtleneck that I thrifted, of course. And, And then this is a jacket from Windsor. I absolutely love this jacket. It kind of leans more fall, and that's when I bought it, but I still have been wearing it a lot this spring, and it's like the perfect lightweight layer. And every time I wear it, I get so many compliments on this, so it's a good one. I'm pretty sure that even though I bought it in the fall, it's still available. So if it is, I will link it down below. And then these are my Levi's. I wear the baggy dad style. And then just my black bag and my New Balances. So let me go to the car and I'll talk to you guys a little bit more.
Do I not have my keys?
Waiting for connection. Bluetooth connection.
Oh my gosh, what the heck just happened to my car? Okay, that was weird. Anyways, hello, hello. Get going. So yes, I am going and getting my dress altered right now. So the girl that is doing my alterations, she's wonderful, and I can tell that she's gonna do a great job and everything. I'm not worried about any of her work, and she's been recommended by like all my vendors, and yeah, I can just tell that she's good. However, first time that I went to her to like give her my dress and everything, she like ran through everything that she wanted to do for my dress. And I honestly like did not think that I really needed much altered with my dress. I kind of just thought some things around the dress needed like trimmed up, but she ran through and she told me that she thinks, or she told me that I would need my dress hemmed, and with the type of fabric that needs hemmed on the bottom, it's like an expensive fabric that is really delicate, and so it would cost a lot to hem it. And she like went through the prices with me, and I realized that the cost of the alterations would almost be the cost of the dress itself, which I'm really not sure if I can justify, because I really didn't think that things needed change with my dress that much. So I think I'm gonna try, well, I am gonna try to tell her today that like I don't wanna get my dress hemmed, because that's where a big portion of the price is coming from. But I don't want to like, I don't wanna feel like I'm like ripping her off, and I should have just told her when I was there the first time, but I was just like shocked and kind of just like taking it all in and confused. But yeah, now I need to like actually be a big girl and tell her, but I'm so nervous because I just feel like she's just gonna be mad at me. As far as wedding planning though, right now we're in a good place, I guess. We honestly haven't been doing that much with wedding planning in the past couple weeks. We're kind of just like getting our RSVPs right now, and have my wedding shower next weekend, which is crazy because that makes it feel, I feel like that is gonna make it feel real and feel like it's coming just around the corner, which it is. It's in less than 2 months now. Okay guys, I am headed to, I'm actually gonna go, I was gonna go home, but we really don't have food at the house right now, so I'm gonna go pick up Town Hall right now and pick up some lunch for Carter and I. So update on my dress. So I did tell her that I didn't want it hemmed, but I tried the dress on again and she was like, it is way too long. I don't know how you're gonna not get it hemmed. So, and then she told me to put my shoes on and walk around for a little bit, and I did. And yeah, I was like stepping all over the dress and could not even walk. And yeah, I'm gonna get it hemmed, even though it's gonna be very expensive, but you know what? Yeah, I was like, I really was unable to even walk around in it. So she was right, she knows what she's doing. I should have just listened to her in the first place. Okay, oh yeah.
Did you get fried chicken?
Yeah, I told you that.
Oh no, this is my broth.
Yeah. I just picked up Town Hall and I want a sip of your broth, by the way. But yeah, I got chicken tenders and fries, so eating like a child right now. And what did Carter get? Burger and bone broth. Hey, healthy king. We're gonna eat right now. Oh. Jingo, you wanna say hello? Say good morning vlog, or good afternoon vlog. Wait, Jingo, look this way. We gotta get that light, right? You sit. Okay, can you say hello to the vlog? Say hello, welcome to a new vlog. Welcome to a new vlog, guys. It's me, Jingle Pops. Hi guys, it is now the evening and I'm finally off of work. Getting ready last minute to go get dinner with some friends. Pretty much ready. Spray this Henry Rose Queen's Monsters perfume on. So good. Oh my God, it smells so good. Also, my mom bought me this little cuticle oil. Shout out to my mom. And it's by Essie, and cuticle oils are it, you guys. I mean, I feel like the only time I ever have a cuticle oil on is when I actually go to the salon and get my nails done, but I remember my mom always had them by her nightstand, and now I feel like I started using one and now I need to use it like every day. So need this. I want to get another one to put in my purse because I like need one on the go as well. And then I need my hand lotion. Okay, hi. I'll just sit here. I went to my bridal trial hair appointment yesterday and she put a bunch of like volumizing products in my hair and it's still all up in there. So I was able to tease my hair. And the curls are still in that she had in there yesterday. So, liking my hair today. Let's see.
I wonder if I wore this in my boots.
Yeah.
It would be.
Yeah. All right, we're gonna head off to dinner now with some friends. By the way, I changed my top, if you're wondering what happened. But anywho, we're gonna head off to dinner now. I'm not gonna film. But we're just gonna go to BrewDog. It's like super casual. We used to go there all the time in the summer, but we haven't been there probably, I think we haven't been there since summer. So it's finally that time of year again. And we might hang out with them after dinner and like come home and watch a show with them that we've been watching, but who knows? We might just end up like talking all night, but but yeah, we're gonna go to dinner and I will catch up with you later, maybe tomorrow morning or maybe tonight. I'll see.
Thank you.
Good morning, guys. I just woke up about an hour ago, and then finally I decided to get out. Whoa, my eye patch is literally on my cheek. What's going on? I probably should take it off by now, but yeah, I woke up a little bit ago, and I just did some laundry, did some cleaning up around the apartment, and now I'm gonna have a little bit of food. I'm just gonna have some kiwis because they're my new fruit obsession. I was like really into apples for a while, and now I've moved on to kiwis. I don't know why, but they're really good. I'm not sure if Carter and I are gonna go to breakfast or not. We were talking about it, but we'll see. So if we go to breakfast, I don't wanna have a big meal right now. I just wanna have some kiwis. I made my little plate of kiwi. I probably definitely could use a smaller plate. Let's air this biatch out. Jingo gets so excited when I do that. Jingo, come here. Come here. Oh, you're a bad boy.
Oh my gosh, Jingo.
Can't believe you did this. I know. We gotta make sure we barricade.
Yes.
This is our pups. His name is Jingle Poppers. Let me see. Hey, drop. Let me see it. This is Jingo's blanket. Hey, that we picked him up from the Amish farm in. And we found it in my trunk, so now he's playing with it again. And it looks like Swiss cheese. Okay, I just made a coffee. Oh, let's see. Put it in a wine glass. My view on stemless wine glasses is that you can really use them for anything. I use this for coffee. Oh my gosh, I use this for coffee. I use it obviously for wine. And then I use it for sparkling water, cocktails. You can use these for anything. I think these ones are from Williams Sonoma or Crate and Barrel. I'm not sure. I can try to find them and link them down below. But this is like one of our most used glasses for any occasion. Also, if you want to see my iced coffee recipe, you can go and look at my other video, my last weekend vlog. I made some mint simple syrup and like showed you guys how I made that. So it's really good. Okay, but right now I'm just going to do my journaling. Oh my gosh, the TV is so loud. It's okay, there we go. Journaling, my gratitude journal. I actually missed yesterday, so I'm gonna have a couple of prompts today. And then these brain games. This is literally the funnest thing ever. There we go. I wanted to show you guys my new toothbrush. Our new toothbrush. We got a double.
New toothbrushes.
Our new toothbrushes. Language 101 with Audra. But we both got a set of these toothbrushes. Mine's kind of gross already, but did you see that? It says good morning. Hold on. Let me do that again. Okay. Oh, you can't see it. It says good morning, but these are bougie AF, but they are actually amazing. My teeth feel so clean. So Carter's.
So queen.
So queen. And what are they called? Oral-B.
Oral-B IO.
It's not ionic. No. It's not what that stands for?
Nope.
No.
I mean, maybe, but it's just the Oral-B IO.
Django. Oral-B IO. And basically, you use this app on your phone. Let me show you guys. It like gives you a score every time you brush your teeth, and it like tells you how much coverage you got. So like last time I got 100% coverage, meaning I brushed all areas of my mouth. But then you also get a score that like tells you if you use too much pressure or too little pressure. And then when you click through, we got, I don't know what version, do you know what?
Seven.
We got seven. Aren't there like nine versions? Yeah, there's a lot of them. We got seven. If you go through, it will, there's like different settings. So
Daily Clean, that's what we use every day. And then Sensitive, Whiten, I've used the Whiten one once or twice. I don't really get that one, honestly. I don't get how it whitens.
They just change how fast and how fast the head like rotates and how much it responds to like the pressure that you put on.
But yeah, it's really cool.
Like a polishing.
Yeah, I feel like the first time or the first couple times I used it, I felt like I just got back from the dentist where when they brush your teeth, it just feels really clean and nice. So I thought I'd recommend those for anyone that is looking for a toothbrush. They are pricey. We got ours in a bundle for like
$300.
So they're pricey, but
you get $100 off if you get a pair.
Yeah, you get a discount if you get a pair. So if you, and also it comes with like traveling stuff too. So I have, we each got these little traveling cases, which is nice. And there's Carter, it came with like one replacement head, but not two. So that was kind of weird, but we'll just have to buy some more of those. But traveling case is nice. So it'll be like a toothbrush that'll just last for a long time, obviously. And you can just replace the heads over time. So thought I would recommend, it's the Oral-B IO, and we got number 7. Okay, here is my fit for breakfast. I got this hat from Zara probably a year or two ago. And then just this random Henley top. Wow, this mirror is really dirty. I clean this mirror all the time, I swear, but it just gets so dusty. And then my Levi's that I wore yesterday, New Balances, and then this is a bag from Zara. And actually, I am going to put some stuff into this bag so that it can like bulk up because it's very empty. So I always put like a towel or something in here in these bigger bags just so it can be really poopy. Hold on, let me get a different towel. I'm literally just gonna put, I'm putting this beach towel into this bag so that it can be not so like limp and it can kind of have some volume to it. This might be too much. Let me see. Oh no, that might be perfect. Might be a little much actually. Let me see. Yeah, it's a little too much. It's looking like a duffel bag right now. So let me do a smaller towel. Okay, I have this. This is a hood to one of my coats that I never wear. So I'm just gonna try to stuff that in there. Let's see. Oh, that might be just right. Perfect. Now it doesn't look so empty. This is what I do. Okay, let me go. Now I actually have to go change out my purse and put all of my different items into a different purse. Mostly just my, oh, I could bring sunglasses. Mostly just my wallet and my keys. And is there anything else I wanna bring in here? I think my buxom is in here, yep. My trusty buxom plump shot gloss. It's the best ever. It comes everywhere with me. Watch out. I go through these tubes of gloss so quickly, but they're so good. They're kind of expensive. I think they're like $24, but they really plump up the lips. And it's just a beautiful gloss anyways. It's like a really thick gloss that looks good on any, on top of any lip liner that you put on. Not wearing any makeup right now. I have this little Marilyn Monroe pimple, this pimple right here, but I have rosy cheeks, but just going barefaced today.
Because look at that. It's like weird. I don't know. I don't think that's right though. But you have to like
leave it in.
I don't know if that's right.
So we went to breakfast a little bit ago. We went to North Star. It's becoming one of our favorite places to go to breakfast. We kind of go there a lot now. It's kind of expensive though, but our food is delicious and
Then we came home, did some tax stuff, which obviously that is boring, so I didn't vlog any of that. Carter is still kind of working on taxes, but I am gonna go to an antique store and I might just like bop around a little bit because I wanna get some gifts for, I wanna get like gifts and a couple of things for wedding stuff, which I can't really talk about because it's gifts and I don't wanna like spoil the surprise for anyone. But yeah, I'm gonna go and do some antiquing. I don't know, I don't really need anything for the house. I kinda wanna take this hat off because it's hurting my head. I feel like I haven't been antiquing for a couple weeks now and it's just a good way for me to like decompress and have some time to myself and like not just kind of like enjoy myself for a little bit. So yeah, that's another reason, just after doing taxes and kind of just being stressed and on edge lately, it just will help me chill out a little bit. So gonna go do that and I'll probably take you along with me. I'm back from running errands and being out all day. Went to the antique store. I went to the Greater Columbus Antique Mall and I was trying to do something there for my wedding, but it just, I wasn't able to find what I was looking for. So I ended up going to Short North and getting some things, but I'm not gonna show any of that just because they're gifts. But I did get a couple of things for myself at the antique mall, so I thought I would show you guys that. I only got three things, but they're all really good. So the first thing is this Madewell sweater. It's really nice material. Oh, actually it's merino wool, but it's really nice material. It's washed out, there you go. But it's like an off-white color and really stretchy ribbed material. So, and then this is like my go-to color, so it'll be perfect for springtime. I got this gold belt. Let me show it to you. This will be really cute. This is like $2 and it will be really cute with dresses or just like a nice little statement that's not too, I don't know, tacky, I guess. But yeah, thought this was a good little find as well. And then the last thing I got, I am very, very excited about. It is this frame of this little girl. It's like a charcoal chalk type of situation. And I thought it was really cute. And I like the gold frame. It's really hard to see, it's so bright. It just matches like my everyday color scheme for our apartment. So this will be really cute. I'm not sure where I'm gonna put it yet, but I feel like wherever I put it, it'll be so cute. Actually, this might be perfect. Let me see. This might be perfect leaning on this little thing that I got a couple months ago. Maybe I'll just leave it here for now. Let me see. There you go. That looks really cute. I could put it there, but then what do I do with my little Django shrine that I had going on? Not sure. I could put it here too. Let's see, I could stack. Could stack some frames right there. That might be cute. How many times can I say cute? That's cute. Would this be better if it was hung up? Maybe. Anyways, I think I'm gonna go on a walk for a little bit and just kind of get some fresh air. It's a beautiful day and I feel like I want to take advantage of it. And I need to make dessert for Easter. I need to make dinner for us and then just do like typical cleaning things that I always do on the weekends. So let me get to it. I think I'm gonna go on a hot girl walk. It's hot girl walk season again, which I'm loving, especially we live downtown Columbus, if you didn't know. We are planning on moving in a few months, so I really have been trying to take advantage of like just being downtown and going on walks and taking it all in before we move away. All right, I'm ready for my hot girl walk
I got this little fanny pack from, I got it for Christmas, I think, a long time ago for my mom. But let me see the brand. It's Buddy Pouch. That's what it's called. And it's like magnetic and really thin. Whoa. Clip it to whatever you're wearing. And you can barely even feel it. And then it has a pouch. I just have my keys in it, but it can probably fit my phone in it as well. I'm gonna go on a little walk downtown just to kind of wake myself up because I'm really tired. And I've been trying to, instead of taking like a 5 to 20 minute nap, which I'm clean of, I have been trying to like go on a walk and have that energize me instead, because the napping,
it's so good, man. Good.
The napping just is not, it doesn't work for me. It just makes me more tired. So yeah, anywho, going on a little walk, eh? I got back from, what was happening? From my walk a little bit ago, and then I got home and I was gonna start making tiramisu for Easter tomorrow. Then I realized I didn't have enough mascarpone cheese. Had to go to Whole Foods, but now I'm back and I'm gonna start making food. I made tiramisu once, and I made it when I was a little girl with my mom. So hopefully this goes well, because I really haven't made it by myself or in my adult life. Yeah, off of barefootcontessa.com, so you can just look up Ina Garten tiramisu and it'll come up. But yeah, hopefully this goes well. Let me get my, this is a baking dish. It's pretty new. I have used it once or twice though, and it's from Anthropology, and it has fun little details on it. I actually registered for this for my wedding, and somebody already sent it to me in the mail, so very nice. But yeah, it's a little 9 by 13 inch dish, and I think it'll be perfect for Easter tiramisu. Oh,
what?
Oh, okay.
What?
I thought we didn't have Kahlua, but we do. I was about to cry. A lot of time has passed, and the tiramisu was a complete fail. I literally had to throw it all in the trash. I just did not make it right. So I made some chocolate chip cookies instead, and I didn't even have all the correct ingredients for those, but you know, we'll make it work, and we don't even have that many because I didn't have enough. I didn't have enough ingredients, and I didn't have the correct ingredients, but here's what we got, and it'll work, I think. We got like, what, 13 cookies, and then we also have Oreos, so should be good enough. I was also gonna make some dinner tonight, but after like the whole baking thing, I just don't feel like it anymore. We ordered Chipotle, and that is on the way. So I think while we wait for that, I'm gonna come in here in the closet and try to figure out what I'm gonna wear tomorrow for Easter, because we're gonna like wake up super early for, we're gonna go to the gym and then have to start getting ready, and I don't want to have to be like dealing or messing around with finding an outfit. So I'm gonna try to figure something out. Good morning, guys. It's just me and Jingle Poppers right now, and it is Easter, so happy Easter. Carter went to the gym. I was gonna go with him, but I just wasn't feeling it, and I need to get in the shower so I can like wash my extensions and do all that. So that's gonna take a long time anyways. I'm gonna make coffee and do my 5-minute journal really quick. We had a cookie. There's a cookie sitting out from last night. And I just tried it, it's really good. It's good. These are made with, I didn't have real flour. I only had almond flour. And I didn't have enough, I didn't have like the amount of flour that I needed for the cookies. But, so I was kind of scared these were not gonna be good, but it's actually pretty good. Pretty good. Not for you. No chocolate for the puppers. No way, Jose. This is poison for you, pups. You can have chocolate. I'm pretty good. I'm gonna make some coffee. I'm gonna put some music on or something. Well, what am I doing? Let me make the coffee first. ADHD. Okay. I was just using this on my eyes and I just dropped it into my coffee. Wow. Crap. Okay. Okay, let me go re-pour my coffee. No mistaking if I'm there, well aware you are always mine. And still you seem so lipstick and my jewelry, so just kind of the finishing touches. I am using this Milani Color Statement lip liner. It's in the shade Spice, number 9. And okay. And then of course I'm going over it with the Buxom Plump Shot. I'm gonna do my gold hoops that I put on like every day. Untangled this necklace for like 5 minutes, but my gosh, struggling. Okay, here we go. Oh my god, there we go, she's on. There we go. Oh. And then my jewel or my rings. I'm gonna wear all of them today because they're kind of colorful and Easter-y. All of my rings, they're kind of colorful and Easter-y, so I'll wear all of them today. That's it. I don't think I could wear this little bracelet. I'll put on this little pearl bracelet as well. I'm wearing these white satin pumps that I got from ASOS. All right, so here is my whole outfit. I am just wearing this white ribbed tee that I always wear, and then this is a skirt that I'm obsessed with. I've only worn it for like a 70s or like a disco themed party once, but I haven't really worn it in real life yet. So I'm excited to be able to finally wear it. I got it at a boutique that was in New Jersey. We're gonna go off to Easter with our family. We're gonna go to church and then I think we're gonna go have lunch with them at their house. But once we get back, I will check in with you guys and lead you through the rest of our Sunday, but I'll be back in a little bit. We just got back from Easter with family just a little bit ago, and yeah, we were gone for kind of a long time because the weather is beautiful right now and we were just sitting outside in the sunshine. It was really nice, but I got home and I got a bad case of the Sunday scaries, so now I'm trying to combat that by cleaning. Do some laundry right now. But yeah, we had a really good Easter. We went to church and the service was really nice. And my camera is flashing red right now, so I think I am gonna end the vlog here and just get into chores, write my to-do list for the week, and just make sure that I have everything in order before I go into a Monday. Next weekend is my wedding shower, so I will vlog next weekend when I go home and go to that. But anyways, thank you so much for watching another vlog, and if you aren't already, you can feel free to subscribe and like this video. That helps me out a lot. And yeah, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye. I wanna be where you are, I just can't walk away.